Is it really? No, I'll just take this. So, as songwriters, our gig is to, we get the phone call going, someone's looking for a song. So we do the research, we see what key they sing in, what kind of grooves they like, and we try to get in their world. And usually we do that with whomever. And when I work with Bon Jovi, his sister Anjovi, I always try to get the vibrato. Wow. I throw it in sometimes. I'm not the only one up here that's funny, Mr. Bird. So you get into the world of what they are, and you try to get into their heads. And I got a phone call from an A&R guy, and he said, do you want to work with America's greatest rock band, Aerosmith? And I went, are you kidding? Yes, I would love that. And Gary, play me some sort of Aerosmith esque thing. Just kind of. So I said, no, I guess. That was my second Grammy. I came up with all of the stuff, the how Steven does it. And I was doing all of that. They fly me to Boston. And it was at Joe Perry's house. And I walked in, and there was Joe Perry standing with his black curly hair in front of his face, a waxed chest with a black leather vest, and a cigarette in his guitar. And I actually made a noise like, It was a brief moment of man crush, because he was like a rock guy. He was a rock guy for me. It's like, Now, the difference is, I mean, you guys don't know me well enough, but the guys up here do. I could talk to shrubbery or a bench. I would need an audience. I talk to, hello, Mr. Pitt, and I can have a whole conversation. And there's Joe Perry, and I had not met Aerosmith before, so I tried to go in with the personality, like, wow, Joe, what a great studio. And Joe Perry is really, really shy, and he went, yeah. I went, wow, you think the Red Sox will ever beat the Yankees? Yeah. You want to go for some chowder? Because we were in Boston, and I tried to have the accent. Maybe later, we'll go for chowder. Anyway, yeah. Now, I'm thinking to myself, this is going to be like kidney surgery. That this is going to be the longest day of my writing life is going to be today. Then a car screeches. The door opens up, and there he was, backlit like a Spielberg movie, with childbearing lips and two tennis shoes. Steven Tyler. And my inner child is going, thank God, someone like me. And he walks in, and we hit it off immediately. And I went, ooh, this is a little bit better. And at this point, all of the songs of the era were like, let's hear it for the boys. White people humping and dancing, clapping on the 1 and 3. Footloose. Oh, God. Oh, sorry. I treaded on the wrong street. I'm always in trouble. And I thought, you know, and Steven, I played my Aerosmith grooves, and Steven went, yeah, that's good. I put a mirror under Joe's nose to make sure he was breathing. And I thought, well, what do you think? And he goes, and then here comes the thing that happens to us as songwriters when you're not expecting it. Steven Todd goes, hey, Marco, let me ask you something. What would you bring to the band if you were in the band? And we're not used to that, but it threw me like, oh my God. And then I just, like a God shot, went, Mark, just do it. And I always was obsessed with John Lennon. He was always my reason for existing. And at that point in time, it was all sort of like, you know, let's hear it for the what? And no one was writing Instant Karma, Give Peace a Chance, Imagine, a song that said something. So I went, well, I kind of have this song. Something's wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes. And Steven went, Stop! And I've never seen a mouth that big in my life. No, there was an Asian family having lunch on his tongue. It was the second noise that I made. Yeah! But there it was. And he went, John Lennon's in the room. John Lennon's in the room. He's in the room! Okay, the song ended up writing itself. After that, it ended up, everyone wanted to work with me. I'm a human genius in my own pants. I won a Grammy. It paid for my divorce and my penis extension. Those aren't cheap. Believe me, Gary, no. Of course, Jen, you had the reduction. Never mind. Okay, so now we're going to do the song now. And there's a part of the record where it stops and there's this big drum beat explosion. Since we don't have a drummer, Vic, would you mind being the voice?
I will do it.
Okay. And when it gets to the chorus, you just, it's in D. But check it out, and this is all serious now, the song, with what's going on in the world today, the song actually makes more sense than the year that I wrote it, with all the words and all this stuff. So check this out. Something wrong with the world today, I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes. God knows it ain't his. It sure ain't no surprise. Yeah, we're living on the edge. Yeah, we're living on the edge. Yeah, we're living on the edge. We're living on the edge. Light bulbs getting dim, it fell down in the sky.